Chris Jenock here for Insight Media Display Week 2023. We're in the PoroTech booth. So PoroTech is basically a fabless micro LED display developer, and they have some unique technology. In particular, they have this PoroGAN material. It's an interface layer that would go between the carrier substrate, which could be silicon or sapphire, and upon which then the gallium nitride epi layers are grown. Now, this PoroGAN material is very enabling because you can now design the epi layers to create either red, green, or blue wafers. And being able to do red in gallium nitride is a big deal. And so doing it in one material system versus indium gallium phosphide is a big deal. So they can create these discrete red, green, and blue wafers, but they can also do another unique innovation, which is their dynamic pixel tuning, DPT pixel. So this actually changes the PoroGAN layer somewhat to allow this pixel now, its defined pixel, to emit any color in the visible spectrum. The PoroGAN layer is really critical to being able to control the indium injection, indium doping, which is what defines the colors in the gallium nitride epi layers. And so if it's a discrete wafer, for example, the PoroGAN layer wants to be very stable. If it's a DPT pixel, it kind of wants to be unstable so it can emit these different colors. And that's their secret technology, is this PoroGAN layer. So what they'll do based on a customer requirement is they will design that PoroGAN layer for a DPT pixel or a discrete wafer. That design and epi layer formulations are done mostly in the UK. That is then sent out to a foundry, a gallium nitride foundry, such as IQE, which is based in the UK and other global locations. That is then, so that creates the epi layers, multi-quantum well epi layers. And then another partner would define the devices through the photolithography and process steps. And then the next steps, of course, are going to be packaging. And that can be wafer-to-wafer bonding if it's an AR or VR kind of device. Or it could be some kind of a mass transfer step if it's going to be a direct view or a larger pixel pitch application. So they're showing over here some of the capabilities that they have in some of these transfer technologies. So the COW here is chip on wafer, and then they can do COC1 is a chip on carrier, so they can do that to maintain the pixel pitch or to spread the pixel pitch. But now you've kind of inverted the LED device, sort of flip it back over, so the bonding areas are visible. You go to a second chip on carrier transfer process. Now they have different partners on this. It could be a stamp kind of transfer process, or it could be a laser transfer. They're somewhat agnostic to that. It really depends on the customer and what the customer wants, which is fine. So let's go take a look at some of their demos. So here's what some of their showing, the products that they're showing here at Display Week. As you can see, this is a 0.12-inch monochrome panels here. They have red, green, and blue that you can do. Here's some of the specifications for these. 640 by 480, 3.75 micron pitch with a 3 micron pixel. That's pretty impressive. I asked them about their EQE numbers. Red is around 10, which is quite good. Green at 40 to 45, and blue at 55%. Those numbers are both at the epi wafer level, but also at the device level. And device is, in this case, about a 3 micron pixel, so something like this. Those kind of EQ numbers at that small device level is impressive. So they are also showing over here, this is their DPT pixel, which is, it's a little hard to see, but that's a fireworks going off inside there. So yeah, this definitely shows that you can get all the colors in the visible spectrum here. And that's, again, based on 0.26. Here's the monochrome versions of the 0.26. These are all basically based on already designed LCOS backplanes. So these are not optimized particularly for a customer application. That's kind of what they would like to do more of, meeting with companies here at Display Week. So you can see some of the specifications on these. And there's even a 0.55 inch monochrome panel over here. And they even have a direct view demo. Let's look at that. So this is a demonstration of what you can do if you mass transfer discrete PoroTech pixels to what looks like a flexible substrate here, perhaps polyimide or something of the sort. But see, they are working on multiple projects for multiple customers that span the range from AR devices to watch scale devices to these direct view kinds of applications like this, which would use discrete. Well, might start with discrete devices, but could move to DPT pixels down the road. So that's pretty much the story. Chris Chinock for Insight Media.